what responses are you getting from people in the college football universe? And do you think one day you will be potentially able to coach in college football again now that all the truth is out?
You know, I'm not sure all the truth is out, Clay, but I do think this makes people think when they flip that coin, you know, there's two sides to it, you know, and, you know, maybe we need to look, you know, past the heads and look over at the tails or vice versa, you know, because, you know, there are a lot of underlining stories that eventually hopefully get out. And I'm, you know, like I said, it's not about me, but it's about, you know, saving reputations and saving people's, you know, opinions that may not be merited, you know. So that's the part that's inspiring to me, you know, just because, you know, we know, and it's hard to live with a cloud hanging over you. But the great thing about the human body and trust and faith and hope is that, you know, you keep those. You keep those intangibles and you live with them. And that's what you coach in football, and that's what you live with in life. So spirit can never be broken unless you allow it to be, and I'll never allow mine to be broken.
Do you think you'll be a better coach now? Do you think you're a better coach now than you were when the situation at Baylor happened and you lost your job there?
I don't think there's any doubt, you know, and I've said all along, you can have all the money in the world, but you can't buy experience, you know, and I've had a lot of experiences, both good and bad, and how you handle those experiences and how you learn from them certainly gives you an opportunity to be a better person and, you know, in this situation, a better coach. So, yes, sir.
What, Coach, one of the things that I like about sports in general, and I'm sure this is initially what helped to draw you into being interested, is sports can make people who otherwise might not have become successful in life successful, either through the sport itself or through the lessons that the kids learn by playing sports. It's why my kids play. It's probably why a huge percentage of our listeners out there, kids play at some point in time. And I think there are important lessons that you learn. One of them is that everybody deserves an opportunity at success. And it seems to me that many of the people that you tried to lift up to get an opportunity to success, they were then used to those guys against you. But I imagine there's so many incredible success stories that we don't spend any time at all discussing that you think about in addition to the wins and the losses from the games itself. There are a lot of lives that you have impacted in an incredibly positive way that without sport, without football, wouldn't have had that experience. Is that what you've seen in your career working from high school to college, now back to high school again in the world of football?
I mean, you're spot on, Clay. I mean, it's extremely humbling. I'll say that, you know, the guys that reach out to me, you know, daily and come see our games and hang out and just, you know, just association. But, you know, the wins and losses, that to me, that's never been the driving force. You know, you got to do it to keep your job and, you know, keep people happy, alumni happy, and, you know, fan base, whatever. But to me, it was all about letting people reach their potential, you know, seeing things in guys that they don't see in themselves and help them bring it out. And, you know, some of my proudest moments at Baylor and at University of Houston was having first-generation graduates, you know, because a little daughter or little son's going to look up at daddy and say, he graduated from college, I can do it too, you know. So to me, it's generational, you know, it changes. And, you know, and it's like I was saying, it's just all about, you know, having confidence in people, giving them confidence, showing them the direction, and then giving them hope and letting them fulfill it. So that to me is what coaching is all about. And it's really about what living's about, what you should do for your fellow man.
We're talking to Baylor football coach Art Briles. Last question for you, Coach. It can be humbling. You know, you climb the mountain, like you said. You end up the head coach at Houston. You move over to Baylor. You're working your way from a small school in Texas high school to a bigger school. And then next thing you know, you almost snap your fingers. And like you said, you're over coaching guys in Italy, spending a year there, and now you're working your way back up in Texas high school football. How do you stay humble, right? Because you've gone from as big a games basically as you can coach in, really in the country, in college football, to being back down into high school, to being over into Italy. To me, it speaks to the fact that you love what you do, but also it requires in you a willingness to humble yourself, to be doing something that's at a quote-unquote lower level than what you might have done before. I think that can be instructive for a lot of people out there listening to us right now who might have a job, they might love it, they lose it, and then they got to work their way back. Have you enjoyed the climb more or trying to sustain success?
I mean, that's really an interesting question, Clay, and I hadn't thought about it. But, you know, to me, it's never been about, you know, being humble or feeling like I'm in a situation that, doesn't deserve, you know, my best. And that's just, you know, who I am. I mean, if I'm coaching football in Mount Vernon or if I'm, you know, coaching in the Cotton Bowl, it doesn't make any difference. You know, my job is to be a coach and to lead and to help these young people and to do whatever we can do to be competitive when we step on the field and put them in opportunities of success. So that's just what it's about. I never got into coaching thinking I want to be an NFL coach or a college coach. I just got into coaching because I love the competitiveness of it. And when you step on the field, everybody's equal. And that's what I've always loved about it. I mean, it doesn't matter who you are, where you're from. It doesn't matter. When you cross that line, everybody's equal, and you abide by the rules that are out there, and the best team wins and the best players win. So that to me, is the driving force of being a coach.
Coach, good luck this season with Mount Vernon. I hope you guys continue to win, and I hope more and more the truth is getting out and you'll get opportunities again to potentially coach in college football. In the meantime, good luck to your family in the SEC West. I know there's a lot of battles going on.
Well, God bless you, and thank you for being a truth seeker, Clay.
Thank you. That's Baylor football coach Art Briles. When we come back, we'll finish out the final hour of the program, Friday edition. I encourage you to go read all the stories we've got up at Outkick about Art Briles, to go listen to that Wins and Losses podcast. I am Clay Travis. This is Outkick, the coverage on Fox Sports Radio.